The graph above shows the number of George's unsold candy bars over a 10-day period. The points on the graph all lie on which of the following lines? Let's see, as the days go by, he has fewer and fewer unsold candy bars all the way until we get to day 10, and he sold all of his candy bars because he has no unsold candy bars left. But anyway, they want us to figure out what could be the graph of the line or the points on the graph all lie on which of the following lines. Let's just think about this line a little bit. So when we're thinking about any line, we could think about, well, what's the slope of this line going to be? So let's see, our slope is our change in our vertical axis for a given change in our horizontal axis. And so let's say that we pick the change in our horizontal axis to be 10. 10 days go by. So our change in our horizontal axis is 10 days. And so what was the change in our vertical? Well, the change in our vertical was 120 candy bars, or negative 120. So we went down. When number of days increased by 10, positive 10, our candy bars decreased by 120. And so what's that going to be? That's going to be negative 12. So we want a line with a slope of negative 12. And immediately when you look over here, you know, we could already start to think about the y-intercept, but immediately when you look over here, the slope is going to be the coefficient on the x. So here, this is a slope of positive 10. That's not right. Slope of positive 10. That's not right. Slope of positive 12, not negative 12. That's not right. Slope of negative 10. That's not right. And right over here, we have our last choice, slope of negative 12. So our choice is E. But we could keep going. Even if this was a free answer, we could still figure this out, because we know that the slope of a line, or the equation of a line, is y is equal to your slope times x plus your y-intercept. Now, we already figured out that the slope right over here is negative 12. And what's our y-intercept? Well, that's what y is equal to when x is equal to 0. When x is equal to 0, when no days have gone by, George has got 120 candy bars. So this right over here is going to be 120. So the equation of our line is going to be y is equal to, even if we didn't have these choices, y is equal to negative 12 times x plus 120. Or you could obviously swap these two around and write it as 120 minus 12x, which is exactly what they did right over here.